presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Let's go to Al in Tampa. Hey, Al, what's going on?
Oh, it's a beautiful thing. I mean, if your listeners don't get the gold report, they're missing out. I mean, with your gold report, you just print in money. I love it.
You're my best ad out there, Al. Let's go to Jeff in New Jersey. Hey, Jeff, what's going on?
Great. Hey, listen, I was calling to thank you. A few weeks ago, you were prompting on your show to fill out that $10,000 grant.
Yes.
So I filled it out, and just a couple days ago, I found $1,000 in my business checking account.
That's awesome, man. That's awesome. Yeah.
And I owe it to you, because if it wasn't for your prompting, I would have just assumed, you know, no way I would have gotten anything. So I wanted to thank you.
No, we appreciate you growling a problem with us yet.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 7 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks, and a great week. We got a short week coming up here. To begin, a great relationship, know what you want. Know what the needs of your body are, what the needs of your mind are, and what fits well with you. There are millions of men and women. Some of them will make a good match for you and others won't. The two years only to be like a key in a lock, a match that works. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 126, NASDAQ's off 79, S&P's down 25, gold contract up $23.90 at $19.72 an ounce. We had silver up 60 cents, $25.59 an ounce. Light sweet crude off $6.50, up $6.23, $100.52 a barrel, notes and bonds. 10-year note, up 26 ticks at 128.18, the 30-year up 15 at 142.17, and King Dollar. King Dollar's up 348 ticks, trading out here at 100.280. Euro is out here at 108. Yen is at 125.39. The British pound's at 130 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world? In the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Well, you have a market, folks, that gave it up on price in an incredible way. But guess what? My take, you're in a bear market. What you're going to do here is that when I just did the update, by the way, it didn't look like we were going to get the volume on the SPYs. We very well might get the spot volume on the SPYs for an ABC structure down, too. And if that's what we got, bottom line, we're going to go after these lows. Right now, you're at 437, 410 is gain. On the Qs, we're going to have it all. The Qs are going to, let me see, it's probably a confirmed ABC down already. We got, we're at 59 million, you need 66. We'll get 66 in the next 10 minutes. That sets up a 317 number, and 317 is the bottom. And I suspect the way this is setting up to see what happens on the queues, folks, check this out. Now, this is going to be cool. So I'm going to give you the bullish and bearish here about will you get a bounce out of this. So you see this, we had one gap that was laid out, you know, last week. You're going to get another gap that was laid out two gaps on one Monday or one on Friday. They don't come in twos, folks. They come in threes. So I suspect what you're going to probably see is you're going to probably see it tomorrow morning, the gap down. Now, if that's what we get, if we get three gaps down and you do go after this low and you test that low with light volume, you very well could basically get close all those gaps again. That'd be the good news. Now, the bad news is this. Whatever way the market gaps like this we're in a downtrending market, that's where the market wants to go. That's how this works, okay? So what I have seen, if it's a three-gap play, if you get the third gap, bottom line, many times they'll go back and fill them up and then see you later again, which could make sense. Bottom line, it's a rough market. You go take a look at the Gold contract has caught a bid, has the volume behind the move, and the magic price here in gold is the close of 1972. We're right at 1972 right now. You had 161,000 contracts today. I'd like to see a little bit more, but yesterday you did have the contract volume that came in. Yesterday we came in with 184,000, and you didn't hold price. And what you can get out of this, you know, I've talked about this many times, that when you get to a price, a higher price, and you have the volume expand and you don't hold price, most times you go right back topside. And that's exactly what we're seeing out here today. There's buyers in the gold market in a big way. And the amazing part about it is there's buyers in the gold market when you have King Dollar laying out here, you know, at 100.289. So King Dollar, you know, bottom line, once again, looks like it's going after this 102 to 103. It's a big number. You know, if we do take a look at the, you know, the bank earnings are coming out, let me tell you, that this is something, folks, that you can really understand technically and fundamentally. So technically, you take a look at J.P. Morgan, okay? J.P. Morgon, bottom line, has just gone in 6 months from $172 to $130. My take, this thing's going a lot lower. When you take a look at this, and this is going to be a problem, right now, J.P. Morgan is below where it was trading pre-COVID. Pre-COVID, it got to 141. We're at 130. You get a high volume swing point down here. Looks to me like J.P. Morgan's running down to like 105. So it's a big number. And what does that say? That says two different things. What has happened is that, yes, the rates have gone up, but the spread is not there because what's going on, the yield curve is inverting. That's the first one. Second one, which I think is more important, what the market is recognizing is this. The bottom line is that who is going to have a bathing suit on because the tide's going out? And when everyone's naked, not everyone, but it's going to be a lot of people naked. What I mean specifically by that is that there are going to be a lot of loans that the banks are on the hook for that, guess what? They're going to go south. That's what this market is saying right now. Because the banks, bottom line, should be higher. You know, and when they're not higher, guess what? That means they're going to be losing money. And the thing that is amazing, there's no doubt, when you just take a look at, you know, the PE, you're talking about a PE of only 11.65. Well, at 11.65, we've been running to like a 15 to 20 PE in this market, folks, okay? So that's saying quite a bit. We got to take a look at the NDX 100, I mean, the IWM, the small caps, same setups. Small caps also are setting up an ABC structure on the way down. It won't take much either. You know, I suspect tomorrow you're going to do that jump. You can see, you know, if you set this up at the lows, you're going to see all the volumes at the lows in the IWM. And the IWM, and, you know, the bottom line is you're down from 244, you're trading 196, and that also wants lower price. So big numbers coming at us. You know, this is the type of bear market that you have, though. You're up. You know, in a monster way, you give it up in spades, they just keep sending it out. Send that paper out, sell that paper, give me that cash. Dow Industrials right now down 174, Nasdaq's off 92, S&P's off 30. Stay right there, folks. We got our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, coming up next. He's going to give us that update. And, of course, you guys, you come over to TFNN. Basil's going to be doing a workshop tomorrow for all the subscribers. Very easy to get into that workshop. We'll talk about it as soon as we come back. Stay right there, folks.
Are you looking for a way to consistently add winning trades to your portfolio? Tom O'Brien is here to help. Tom O'Brien has been successfully trading markets for over 30 years. A frequent contributor to TD Ameritrade Network and CNBC, Tom O'Brien founded TFNN over 20 years ago to help educate investors just like you. Tom's daily market newsletter, Market Insights, is published every morning when the markets open to give you the competitive informational edge you need to succeed. These newsletters are packed full of Tom's advanced technical analysis and are geared to deliver comprehensive strategies for a successful portfolio. Get Tom O'Brien's newsletter, Market Insights, today and try all of our products and newsletters 30 days risk-free with our money-back guarantee at TFNN.com. TFNN. Educating investors.
What's separating you from the most successful men and women on Wall Street? That's right. information. Having all the information gives us the perspective we need to place the right trades at the right time. The TESS Profile Scanner is the premier market profile-based scanner. Powered by its acclaimed TESS proprietary algorithms, this feature-rich scanner instantly filters over 2,500-plus global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodities, futures, and Forex. This powerful suite of tools leverages instant trade filtering and strategy formulation to show you emerging trades before they happen. For a limited time, you can save $100 off your first month by using the promo code UPGRADE. And you still get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Level the playing field with the TASS Profile Scanner, which you can find under the Services tab at TFNN.com. Sign up today.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV. Live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern for free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow. Dow Industrials right now down 159. We get the Nasdaq off 85. S&P's off 27. Let's get over to our man, Mr. Basil Chapman, as we do each and every Tuesday at 20 past the hour. And don't forget, folks, Basil has an outstanding show here every trading day, 10 to 11 Eastern Standard Time. Also has a great newsletter. Now, Basil's going to be doing a workshop tomorrow, folks, from 4 to 5:30 for all his newsletter subscribers. It's very easy to be a newsletter subscriber, so you can get in this workshop, really learn about a lot about the market, learn a lot about the Chapman Wave. The way you do this, you just come over to our website at TFNN. You're going to see the opening call right under featured content. You're just going to hit subscribe. You can get into the opening call and the newsletter and the workshop for $149 for 1 month, $695 for 6 months, where you save $199 or 22%. You can get it for a year for $1,195 and save $593 for the full year. Now, what happens, folks, is this, is that it comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you can go check it out. You can get the newsletter, get a great newsletter, get in the workshop tomorrow. If it works for you, 30 days from now, guess what? You know, bottom line, if it doesn't work for you, you can just say, I want a refund. You get a full refund, no questions asked. Basil has a lot of other workshops right on the webpage, which is dynamite. And, of course, you know, he does an amazing workshop. That's going to be tomorrow, 4 to 5:30. Basil Chapman, what's going on?
Hi, Tom. How are you?
I'm doing good, man. And thank you for doing my show yesterday. I appreciate it.
Pleasure, as always. This is going to be, I think, timing-wise, this is good because we're at the cusp. This is really important. One of the reasons why I wanted to do this workshop is for some time now we've been raising cash because I have not liked the shorter-term aspect to the market. The monthly charts, I'll talk about that in a moment. But what I wanted to do is to say what needs to go right technically. Geopolitically and all that, that's beyond us. But what can the market do? What does it have to overlook? So these are all the technical aspects that I'd be looking for higher prices. So basically, you know, even from we've been discussing for, you know, for ages, I look for a lowest low bar. I count E successively peak. I alphabetize them A through G, but it's at the fourth highest peak, peak D, that other things can happen. Well, just have a look here. You got the Dow. makes a peak D all-time high at 36.952, and a source has declined from the 5th of January. It has this rally just recently to about March the 24th or so. It goes to 35.372 to a peak D. If you look at the S&P, where did it turn around? The fourth high, where did I type that? Whoops, typed in the wrong place. There it goes. I type it in and I give you an S&P at this particular point. 46.37 was the high at peak D. Just that was also August, around about the 28th. And here it is at 43.90, just underneath the 200 period moving average. These are all very simple techniques that I'm going to be teaching. But here's one that I think is absolutely critical. And I'll just show you this right here. So this is the big question I have is it possible for the stock market to make new all-time highs in 2022? This was, I actually set it up, I spoke to Tommy about this before there was even talk about Russia and Ukraine. But what I was looking at is, what would be the technical aspects? And let me just show you something here. This is always a shocker to me when I show it. You see this green line right here, one of the techniques that I'll be teaching. So this is 2010, February, at S&P was at 1100. It's hard to believe that even with that 35% decline, that was a two-month decline, February, January, February of into March low back in 2020.
Yes.
It is still green. Not once has it turned pink. Pink is usually negative. Green is positive. And that's a technique that I'll be showing. So it means that even with the most recent 14% decline in the S&P from the 48.18 all-time high in January of this year, here we are, green, and the prices at this particular point are still above the green line.
So Basil, tell me what that green line is again.
So this is the 9-period exponential moving average.
I see. Okay.
When it crosses the slower 14.
Okay. Yep.
I mean, I wouldn't believe, every time I look at it, I say, how could that be? How could it have been in that massive decline, 35%? Back in 2020, that is still remained green. So this is the very long-term perspective that I like to give it. But here's something else. There's a particular way of looking at it. This is the S&P again. This goes all the way back to 1998. There was a little mini minus 22%. Not mini, but it was a minus 22%. It looks mini because of the chart until the high that was made at 2000. And my question, based on the MACD, the moving average, convergence, divergence, and the slow stochastic, is those things match very well. That particular decline in 1998, is there a chance that we do continue the consolidation a little longer, but in 2022, we start to move higher, and could we move up for about another year? And that's a big question that I'll be dealing with. So those are very important, as well as, for instance, today, I like to do things live, because that's really, to me, the big test is, it's all very well looking back 2020. In hindsight, everybody's perfect, but it's in real time. So what I was discussing is that for subscribers, we have some stocks that are testing highs at this particular time. And I said, you know what? This looks to me like the when I did my show this morning at 10 o'clock, my Tiger Technician's Hour, I said, look at this. At 9 o'clock, the S&P ran up to a high around about the 46, I think, 59 area. And then I said, as we're coming on the air, look at the difference between the MACD, the moving average convergence, divergence, and the stochastic here at 9 o'clock. And look at 10 o'clock. It's much weaker. Well, it turns out that was the top of the day at 44.66.75. And here we are. We've just made a little low at 43.70. We're at 43.85. And look at the 200 period, how it was fantastic support for so long. This is the pink line here. And look out for support, and then it became resistance. So these are very simple tools. I want to include them. I'm not just going to give a webinar where I say, this is what we are looking to buy because we've raised cash. We're going to be looking to put money to use. At the same time, I could quite easily also go short. There's no problem with that. But I'm saying there are positions, and especially in the commodity area, that we have. I mean, you were just speaking a moment ago about the dollar. We've been long the dollar since 90.07 back in 2018 in a very long-term move that went all the way to 102.99. plunged again to 89.21, and here it is back at 100 at par. It's amazing. And I'll talk about the rectangle formations, how the narrow rectangle formations have a certain duration at a certain point. If it breaks to the upside, it's very good. But if it just keeps going that way, you've got to be careful that it won't break down. So here we are at new recovery highs. If you look at the dollar in the very long term, you can see there's a very big rectangle formation. And that just says the dollar is the currency in demand right now. If you look at the DBA, we've been long the commodity area for a very long time. I talk about these double tops in the rectangle formation. And look what happened. It went to 22.64. This is the DB Agriculture Fund. It went to test the 22.64 high that was made in March. And we just broke to the upside. So some of these are really simple tools that I'll be teaching, but at the same time, we're going to be looking at, for subscribers, who people who join, they'll be able to look at my work and say, hey, these are the stocks that we're looking at. Where do we start putting money to work? And it's going to be really fascinating.
And it's very easy to get into, folks. Go to TFNN. You're going to see the opening call right on that front page. Hit that button and you are off to the races. Basil, have a great one, safe one. We look forward to the show tomorrow.
Thank you, Tom.
Thank you. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Trading the markets, but having trouble finding like-minded individuals to discuss your trading and investment ideas with? Become an apex predator in the trading markets and join the Tiger's Den Trading Room only at TFNN.com. The Tiger's Den is an exclusive trading room where successful traders from around the world come to exchange trades and ideas. Join the Den and surround yourself with the sharpest minds in the trading world. Subscribers to the Tiger's Den are also the first to have their questions answered live on air and can privately chat with our TFNN hosts live during their shows. Interact with other Tigers and Tigresses as they share trading ideas, news analysis, and discuss the market action all trading day. Subscribe to the Tiger's Den risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee and become part of the TFNN trading community. TFNN, educating investors.
You could be making money off the stock market. And if you're already making money off the stock market, you could be making a lot more. Check out TFNN and Tiger TV and get expert investing advice to give you the power to control your financial future. Go to TFNN.com and find the newsletter for you. Whether you're into trading gold, metals, futures, currencies, or options, you'll get advice and analysis to help you seriously get ahead. TFNN also features trading services with a 30-day money-back guarantee for new subscribers, as well as TFNN's Tiger Den Trading Room, trading software, and educational webinars for all trading levels. And make sure you check out Tiger TV for free on TFNN.com or TFNN's YouTube channel for live financial content from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern on market days. Stop watching on the sidelines while other people get rich and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now down 203. We get the NASDAQ off 88. S&Ps are off 30. So let's go take a look at the S&P futures right now, because what they're doing, folks, is that they are hammering the lows. And let's just see in a 10-minute where we're at. We're just starting this 10 minutes, so let's see what we have here. So you just broke, let's see how many days. Let's do this, 6 days. See how this sets up. Okay, so you broke down period. That's quite a swing. Oh, so that was, let's see, 32,000 contracts versus 39. So you don't have an ABC structure down. Intraday, this is. That's what I'm trying to figure out, intraday. So you're in the top of this bar is what? 43.67. Oh, that's game. So 43.67 is game right now. And this is the bar. So this bar here, folks, I'm going to bring, let me bring the SPY up. Because it's the bar as we come off the bottom, the second bar. And that the second bar has some volume in it. That's why I suspect actually tomorrow it's going to jump it. So that's from the 16th of March. The top of that is 435. This wants the gun for this 435 right now. That's how this is shaking out. You know, that's in the SPY. If we go to the Qs, I think it's already dug into that bar. And the Qs, the top of that bar is, yeah, it has. So that's 340. The Qs are already at 338. That just sets up the bottom end. And this could be a real problem. You know, the bottom line is that you have a short week, meaning that there's no market on Friday. You're going to get a lot of action out here Wednesday and Thursday. There won't be a lot of action on Friday. Well, there'll be no action on Friday because we're closed. But you will get some big action tomorrow and the next day. And what we did have is this. So check out these volumes, okay? You know, we're talking about when you have higher, when you go higher, folks, what ends up happening is that you have wide price spread, you have accelerated volume, real market that goes higher. When you come lower, it's just the opposite. And you can see when you start looking at some of these volume characteristics, that's exactly what we've had. You know, the bottom line is that what we're going to have out here today is going to be really intriguing because what it is this. You're going to have, you went to a higher price, and you're going to have lighter volume. And that's exactly what's supposed to happen. And this one here can get a little confusing, you know, as to the aspect, okay, well, how does the time of the trade work? Because it's always a price and volume deal, what we did do is that we got higher first. So when you get higher first, you have a contraction of volume simultaneously, and we end up down. That is very hard to do. Meaning, it's hard to do that the volume will still contract. And if that's what we get, guess what? Get out of the way. Because that basically, you know, is giving us another confirmation that this market wants lower price. That's how that thing shakes out. We go take a look at the Dow Industrials, inside the Dow Industrials and see strength versus the weakness out here. Point-wise, what we have, you have Chevron putting 21 positive points, Apple 10, Dow 6, taken away from it. United Health 42, Microsoft 26, Visa 24. Microsoft, it's a mind blower. Microsoft is like trading like a penny stock, meaning that the moves are extraordinary, man. I mean, it's crazy. Microsoft, you know, 2 days ago was $296 and it's $281 today. And Microsoft's firing off with volume, man. It has a high volume low. So picture, in 5 days, Microsoft's gone from 315 to 281. Well, that's not the bottom line, folks, because the bottom line is that this has high volume lows. It looks to me like you set up a much larger ABC structure down. And if that's what we have, you're talking about some real numbers. I mean, you're talking about a 60-point A to B. Well, that's 50. 1 second. That's 80. So you're talking about, what, 235. Where's 235? Yeah, 235, man. Microsoft, so the way, if we break this B point with volume, Microsoft's talking about going all the way back to the aspect of September of 2020. That's how that baby's set up. And if that's what we get, guess what? It's going to be pretty intense. We take a look at the NDX 100. And a lot of these equities already, by the way, basically 30 to 35% lower in the market in general. If we take a look at the NDX 100, what do you have? You get CrowdStrike up 3%, Ross Stores is up 2.5%, Lululemon is up 1.4%. Taken away from it, IDEX Pharmaceuticals down 4%. You get Match.com off 3.6%. DocuSign is down 3.2%. And AstraZeneca is off 3. Let's go to the big dog, Amazon, see what Amazon is doing out here. So we take a look at Amazon. That's down 10 bucks. You know, so in a couple weeks, we're down from 3,400 to 3,000. That's 15%. And Amazon's going after these high volume lows, too. We're going lower, man. That's the bottom line. What you've got to see during these few weeks is that what building cars is all about. What happens with building cars, folks, is that you take a leg down, you go sideways for a bit. And the way that you can understand if you're building cars on the way down is that each time that you pop up, you come up with lighter volume. Each time that you go down, it accelerates. Normally, you'll go sideways for a bit and just take the tops and the bottoms and see where the most volume is. That is the aspect of building cars on the way down. If we're building cars on the way up, what ends up happening, and at some point we will. I mean, you know, that's just how markets go. So if we were building cars on the way up, what would end up happening is that each time that we go higher, you would see the volume expand. And as we come lower, you know, on the channel, the volume contracts. That's building cars for the way up, you know. So interest rate structure-wise, you know, what do you have out here? You get a bounce out here today or 2.7 in the 10-year. If we take a look at this 10-year wants to go to 117. Right now you're at 120. We hit 119.10 out here today. If we take a look at the volume out here, you get two million contracts. That's good contract volume, by the way. Okay, so let's just take a look at it. That's a good bounce. So this does look like it wants to bounce, but not bounce far, man. I'm talking about maybe you get one, well, I was going to say 120.30. That's only 12 ticks above where we are right now. And yeah, I can bounce there. You know, it hasn't got to a swing point yet. The swing point inside of the 10-year, folks, okay, is 121.04. And right now we got to 120.26. Bottom line is that my take, these interest rates are going up dramatically from here, not in a small way. That's my take out here. Dow Industrials right now down 156, NASDAQ's off 62, S&P's off 24. Pretty amazing, gold caught this bid with the dollar being so high. We take a look at the silver market, silver also caught the bid. Has volume behind the move too, up 57 cents, 67,000 contracts. Silver's going for this $30 mark. Stay right there, folks. We'll come right back. We're going to be talking with Robert from Kansas City. We're going to be talking about the XLF because the bankers are starting to kick off the earnings numbers, folks. We'll be right back.
Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay Area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
The technology around us is changing every day. With so much happening, it can seem impossible to keep up with all the information. David White's investment newsletter, The Technology Insider, is designed to give you all the information you need to understand the technology that shapes today's markets and tomorrow's future. David White has made his living staying on the cutting edge of technology. His weekly newsletter will give you specific recommendations for value tech stocks, as well as entry prices, target prices, and stops to set for each trade. Dave delivers his weekly newsletters every Friday with updates throughout the week. You can get the Technology Insider at TFNN.com for only $37.50. Sign up for David's newsletter, The Technology Insider, and get an inside look at everything the technology sector has to offer. Try it risk-free today with our 30-day money-back guarantee. TFNN, educating investors.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrial's down 140, Nasdaq's up 50, S&P's up 23. Let's go to our man Robert in Kansas City. Robert, what's going on, brother?
Hey, Tom. Thanks for taking my call.
Absolutely, man. Thanks for calling. Appreciate it.
Thank you. I wanted to bounce a question off of you. So I went short XLF about a week and a half ago, and then I covered my position last Thursday or Friday, and I was kind of hoping we'd get a little more of a bounce. It hasn't bounced as much as I wanted it to, but we got a little bit. So I'm ready. It seems like it's turned down now, and it's ready to kind of complete its pattern. I'm ready to go short again. My question to you is, do you think the XLF will go below the, the March 9th lows? So if you look at kind of the first turn down from January the 13th, it went down to, the end of January, and then it bounced back up, and then it went lower on March the 8th. Do you think that's kind of where it's destined to land, and then it'll pop back up and then try to bust down again, or what are you thinking? And I know you don't have a crystal ball. I just wanted to get your thoughts.
No, absolutely. So let's take a look at it. So we got the XLF. The XLF, folks, is the financial select spider, okay? Inside it, holdings-wise, what you have, you get Berkshire Hathaway's 15%, J.P. Morgan's 9%, Bank of America 6%, Wells Fargo 4%. So when we take a look at this, okay, this stock, this ETF, my take is in trouble, no doubt. And so to answer your first question about down at the bottom, yeah, I believe it's going to go to that 35.49. The larger deal is it looks like it's going to be an ABC down. We get 40, 1 second. So 40, that's only 4 points. Okay, so now let me put this on a weekly. I'll show you on the weekly and this is the idea of, let me put it on the monthly so it'll be a lot clearer when you're watching Tiger TV. You can see when you're watching Tiger TV, right? See, the last time that we came down, that's a high volume low already. That's laying it out at 35.49. Now watch this. I'm just gonna put this on a weekly, folks. So when I was just talking about how building cars and the way up versus the way down, how it sets up. So if I put this on 2 years, yeah, cool. This is the cool thing about when something has been consolidating for a long period of time, you can get a clearer picture of what it's trying to do. So if we bring this back, the consolidation actually started this is a mind blow, folks, a year ago. This thing has been consolidating for a year. Now watch this. What you do is you take the tops versus the bottoms. So the first time down, going all the way back in June, Robert, you can see 35.80 had some volume, right? On a weekly, 465 million, okay? Now watch the high. So that's the low. We get to a high with 223. We get to a low with 497. We get to a high with 318. We get to a low with 548. You get to a high with 332. You get to a low with 468. all of those numbers. If you do those percentage-wise, they're dramatic. That's saying it's going to come down there, number one, and we'll see whether it busts it. You bust that consolidation, and this will be, let's see, the top. Let's see. All right there, 41. It's not that bad, 5 points. So that brings it down to like 31. If we bust it, 31's the next stop. There's not much there, though, but that's how this is setting up. So, you know.
All right, well, thank you.
Yeah, you know, it looks to me like, and that's telling me a huge amount about kind of like where we're at. Because it's very surprising that in a higher interest rate market, which we have, is that the banks are going down. You know,
it's a little bit counterintuitive.
It is.
But I guess, you know, we live in this complex world where it's hard to figure out everything. I mean, the offset was, it's like you said, if we go into recession and they're having to write off loans, that offsets the higher interest rates and they're not lending as much, right?
Exactly. And what has happened is that they're not dealing with the spread. Normally what happens is that you're dealing with the spread. And they're not dealing with the spread because the 10-year is 2.7 and the 2-year is 2.3. That isn't how it normally runs. Do you know what I'm saying?
So it's like, don't have enough, so that's not enough spread to make the money.
No, not even between 2 and 10. No, they're looking for, you know, you're looking for basically a 2% spread, which normally would, you know, that's how, I mean, what you can see, you can almost get the same amount of interest on a 2-year for a 10-year. Well, what are you going to do? I'll take the 2-year, right? You know?
So normally they're looking for 200 basis points between the 2 and the 10?
Easy. Yeah. Just to basically, the least amount of money they can basically, you know, bring it in and then send it out. That's where they make all the money. And the spread between what they can get money for and what they send money out for.
And what's the spread now for the 2 and the 10? You said that, but I didn't catch it. I'm sorry.
It's not even 0.5%. It's okay. 2.7 is the 10, and 2.37 is the. So you're talking about what? You're talking about 350 basis points. That's it.
Wow. Yeah. Well, yeah. Thank you for providing that insight. That's helpful.
Okay, man. Have a great one. Have a safe one.
You too. Thank you.
Thanks. So we had a question in the den also, is that about what would it take policy-wise to help save the U.S. markets? So what happens here, folks, is not even a policy deal to put that, because what we have is this. Okay, so let's talk about what inflation is. Inflation is that there's too much money chasing the goods. So there's more money than there are goods. That's the first part. Then the second part is really important to understand, though. It's the velocity of the money that goes through the economy. You know, I buy something off Robert. Robert, bottom line, has money. Robert goes to Frank. He basically gets something off Frank. Frank goes to Jimmy. Jimmy comes to me. It's the velocity of that money that goes through the economy. The velocity of money that we've had in this economy is phenomenal. And the velocity of the cash that is turning is amazing. That's true inflation. The only way to whack that down, folks, is to do what? Is to suck the money out of the economy, which the Fed has told us flat out that's what they're doing. They're doing it two different ways. They're doing it in the aspect of they're going to raise rates, which they've done. The market's raising rates also, which they've done. And they're going to stop buying bonds. Okay, so, like, do you have an extra $1 trillion out there right now to buy the bonds they're not going to buy? So, when you're looking at any asset price right now, that's what you have to understand. That you have a pile of cash. That pile of cash, if we're using our signature, that signature is just worth less money. If you're basically looking for asset prices to rise, it's going to be pretty hard to rise, because the Fed has been buying mortgage-backed securities and they've been buying treasuries for the last, who knows, we're talking a long time. This is the first time that I think you're going to see an acceleration in rates since 1994. And if you're around in 1994, guess what? Every single time, I mean, that's when I really got to understand what a punch bowl's all about, man. and it stinks when they take it away. You might like, not like the Fed, all of that stuff. The bottom line is that when that punch ball's gone, guess what? We're going south. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
You might think that if you want to be successful at trading in the stock market, you're going to need a crystal ball. After all, it's impossible to predict the future, right? Like any endeavor in life, before you decide it's impossible, get some advice from the experts. You might find that it's not so impossible after all. For daily market overviews that give you direction on the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, subscribe to the Opening Call newsletter at TFNN.com. The Opening Call newsletter is written by Basil Chapman, creator of the trading methodology known as the Chapman Wave. The Chapman Wave up-down sequence gives you an edge in identifying price turns, finding the peaks and valleys in stock prices. Get the Opening Call newsletter by Basil Chapman in your inbox every day. First-time subscribers also get a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you're not satisfied, let us know, and you'll get a full refund within 30 days of signing up. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Are you having fun trading the markets but having trouble finding like-minded individuals to discuss your trading and investment ideas with? Become an apex predator in the trading markets and join the Tiger's Den Trading Room only at TFNN.com. The Tiger's Den is an exclusive trading room where successful traders from around the world come to exchange trades and ideas. Join the den and surround yourself with the sharpest minds in the trading world. Subscribers to the Tiger's Den are also the first to have their questions answered live on air and can privately chat with our TFNN hosts live during their shows. Interact with other Tigers and Tigresses as they share trading ideas, news analysis, and discuss the market action all trading day. Subscribe to the Tiger's Den risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee and become part of the TFNN trading community. TFNN, educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's down 100, Nasdaq's off 40, S&P's off 18. So let's go over and take a look at the Qs, see if we got the volume in those Qs for an ABC structure on the way down. You needed 66 million, you got 67 million. They'll throw another 5 or 6 million at the close. We take a look at the S&Ps. I don't think the SPY is going to have the volume. It was way, well, look at this, man. Holy cow. Now we'll see. You get 74 million, 89. I mean, there's not, you get 6 minutes, 11 minutes left. They get 6 plus another 5 on top of it. But that being said, I expect what you're going to see out here tomorrow is that it's just going to gap lower. That's how this thing seems to be setting up right now. If we go take a look at it's KNTNF. This is a gold equity. I don't know a lot about this gold equity. K92, low is 442, the high is 768. It looks like I just pulled it up, and they're doing business in Guyana. And bottom line, you are taking out a swing point with volume. So you get 756. Last time you popped up there, you had 430 million. You're 382. I wouldn't buy it right now. I would try to, if you have it, I'd probably move it out because what this should have closed over, it's only a penny away from it today. It's a new one, and I'll do some more work on it, but I really just don't know fundamentally enough about that one. Market-wise out here, the bottom line is that you're going lower, and what you're going to have out here today is you're going to have a market that didn't hold price, and so I suspect we're going to have, on the indices, lighter volume at the high. We're 620 right now on the NYSE, on the composite, you're at 4.4. It's gonna hold up, man. So you went higher, couldn't hold price, closed lower. That's setting up lower prices coming at us. Always remember, folks, the bear can claw your heart out, the bull can run you over, and thank God there's always another trade. Health, happiness, and prosperity. Have a great night, folks. Have a safe night. Come back and visit Tommy tomorrow morning. Kicks us off 9 o'clock in the morning. Great show. Go get him, folks.